Thank you for joining us today and learning more about the Data Cookbook by iData, the leading data governance solution for institutions of higher education. This is part of a series of videos providing details on the benefits and features of the Data Cookbook. We hope you find them helpful. In this short video, we'll provide an overview of the features around data systems and technical metadata in the Enterprise Edition of the Data Cookbook. I'll start by logging into the Data Cookbook, and I'm going to be going to the new Data Systems menu and clicking on Browse Data Systems. This brings me to a complete inventory of all of the data systems that we have on campus. Data systems in the Data Cookbook can represent specific databases or systems used to store data. They can also be used to represent protocols like flat file structures, APIs, or other interfaces. We can group the data systems to keep related systems together and easy to find. There's also a quick search at the top of the screen that allows someone to help quickly find a particular system, as this list might end up growing pretty large. This inventory of data systems allows you to track and show information about each system, including the contacts shown here on the right, or information about the technology used here in the center. There's also quick links right in the middle there to show you all of the different kinds of objects using this data system. The definitions and specifications, collections, and quality rules. And there's a general description on the left. We can drill into one of these systems to get more information. Once we're inside a particular data system, there's additional information regarding the access information and location of that data system. You can also add your own custom fields for additional attributes that you'd like to track. A major feature of the data systems, then, is the data model that you can be tracking. And this data model can be represented from the technical information in your database, and it can be connected to with our data management connectors, bringing in all of the information regarding all of the tables and columns and views from your database. And here we see a large list of tables that are available in this schema for this particular data system. And a user can navigate through all of these tables and the different columns. I'm going to a particular table right now, SPB PERS. And so I will go into that table. There's also a search through this metadata that you can do to quickly jump to a table or a column name or a view name. Right? When we're looking at a particular table, we have the ability to view a representation of the relationships that it has based on the information from that foreign key and primary key relationships that exist in your database. Those ERD diagrams can be made available to provide that graphical view of those relationships based on that metadata. In the list of the columns for a table, we see a link out here to be able to create a definition. This allows a technical user to initiate a definition from the specific data system object and to establish that relationship. Foreign key information is also shown here, and you can follow the links to other parts of your data model. So here I find the STV SITS table, and so I can click on that, and that will bring me to this table information within my data model. And when we're looking at an individual element, I'll go down here a little bit into this table and click on the description code. When we're looking at an individual element, we can see additional information about this item, and down lower we can see other relationships and information it has that we've tracked in the Data Cookbook. So in this case, we show how it is being used in a lineage that maps over to the citizenship definition. And this lineage is built in what we call an ETL specification that's done in the Data Cookbook, in another set of features where we have advanced specifications. You can be writing ETLs, documenting the ETL processes, as well as more complex reports. So here is a link straight to that specification that can show me more information about that specification. Right? Other relationships would also appear down here if this was used in a definition or if it was used in a quality rule, and so on. So this technical metadata that we've got now loaded in and connected in with the data system is really a foundation for all of the additional elements across the data cookbook, from technical definitions to technical information on quality rules, connecting it to your reference data, which are your sets of code values like your valid majors or valid academic programs. Also connecting to these lineages that are drawn up from your ETL specifications. While working with any of these objects, the user is provided a quick pop-up browser to help them navigate and select the right data model objects. To see this in action, we're going to go to a particular definition, and we will take a look at how that browser appears. So I'm going to a specific definition, and I'm going to work on the technical part of this definition. So I will pull that up. I will choose to edit it. And when we're working on a definition, down in the technical area, we now have the ability to browse the data system and identify additional metadata. So I can go browse through the data system and choose, it's going to look through the metadata in this particular ERP system. I can choose the schema that I'm searching and start to look for a particular table. And it will find that phrase in these tables and these columns. I can click on the table, see the table name here, and then I can get in to the different codes. I can take these codes and drag them and drop them into my technical definition to add a new relationship. So with this, I can be building up parts of a query, or I can just be making a reference to a particular element in my data system. And that is a way to use that pop-up browser to establish a relationship between this definition and that one particular data element. And with these relationships established, we can then see from any one of these objects, we can see what other objects it's related to in the data cookbook. And if this metadata changes, then we would understand the impact, the impact on the various objects. In this case, this degree code is being referenced by a definition, as well as by a quality rule, as well as being used in this student dimension table ETL. So if our data systems changed and this element was affected, the data cookbook would be alerting us to the impact on these other three objects, right? So that is how these are all connected. Again, this rich technical metadata is then utilized by technical definitions, quality rules, reference data, and lineages, and then changes in them, of course. If the metadata changes, then it assesses, alerts you to the impact on all of those. So that is a quick overview of the data system and technical metadata capabilities of the Data Cookbook. Thanks again for joining us today and hearing about the Data Cookbook. Please watch our other videos located at datacookbook.com/videos. You can also learn about the Data Cookbook at datacookbook.com/tour. And remember, there is a community focused on data management at community.datacookbook.com, where you can access information regarding data governance, reporting, and data definitions. Have a great day.